One thing I forgot to mention in the previous video was that also you want to also take apart the octave assembly on the neck, and that's simply held in by a rod usually, and you simply unscrew the rod. And then the neck will just pop off. The neck octave will pop off. And if it's easier, since it is a very small rod, you can just get a small screwdriver, press through the opening to get it to pop out. And off comes the octave. So after you have taken apart your saxophone and you've cleaned each of the keys and cleaned the horn and done your maintenance on the pads, now it's time to put it all together. And yeah, it looks like a gigantic jigsaw puzzle, but it's actually very simple. And usually what you want to do is you want to keep in mind as you're taking it apart what the order you took it apart was, so you can reassemble it in that same order. So in the last video, the last key I took out was the side F sharp, which was this one, the alternate side, whatever. So we're gonna start with this one. So now what you wanna do is you wanna keep in mind, put on the key, set it up, put in the screw and hold it in, or the rod, whichever. Once you've done that, you want to check the motion of the key. If you tighten the screw too much, like here, the key does not move freely. You have to force it back up. So you want to tighten the screw just enough that it stays tight, but yet the key is able to move freely. So that's the critical key to putting it back together. Afterwards, put on the spring and then try it out. If it works, you've done it correctly. Next, we're going to put together the side, the low C and E flat keys. And the easy way to do it is to first put in the key in the little guard. Line up the E flat. You want to put in the rod just enough that it keeps the key in there, or you put the C key in there also. And then just slide it in. And then screw it in. On rods, however, there is no too tight, too loose to prevent motion. They allow motion no matter how tight the rod is, but you don't want to tighten the rod so hard that next time you want to take it apart, you can't take it apart. But also, to keep in mind, is that you want to be sure you're using the right size screwdriver so that when you are trying to tighten or loosen these rods, you're not stripping the actual groove on it with the flathead. Because next time you want to take it apart, you're not going to be able to because you have a stripped out rod, and that's not good. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to assemble the lower, the right hand keys. And the way to remember which keys go where is you want to find the largest of the pads and put that first. Then the pad with the pearl in the middle is your middle finger on the keys. And then the one with the pearl on the right side of the pad, and also the smallest one of the three, is your index finger key. In addition, this key also came off with them, and that fits in right between the low D and the low E. And I'll show you how that works. Afterwards, you want to put the next key in order of how the rod goes through. So that means this key will go second. And that will fit between my D and post. So we want to set that in. And then since that's the first key, what we're going to do is we're going to take the D back out so we can lift the horn. And we're going to take the rod. Remember to insert it in the hole on the other post before putting it in the main post. Next comes the F, and we'll just put that in there. Okay. Next comes the F sharp or E. And finally, the D key comes in. And once you've done that, all that's left to do is tighten the rod. And then you put the springs back on. And you want to pay attention to which springs go to which key. And then as you're putting on the keys, as you're putting on the springs, lift the key with your finger so the spring will engage. As you can see, it works. And I'll do that for the rest of them, and I'll be right back. So once you've put on the springs to the lower hand keys, you want to verify one function. That every time you press one of the keys, this top key goes down with it. You want to verify that that works. If it does not work, then you haven't assembled something right. And although I doubt your saxophone will go together any other way except this one, you should double check it, just in case something goes wrong. The next thing we're going to put together is the left hand keys, the top ones. And this is a little trickier, because there are multiple keys. So what you want to do is you want to sort out which keys go where. So the key with the really tiny pearl, that's the bis key. So you want to keep that aside. This key looks like my B, because the front F will go on top of it like that. So we know that these two will go together, something like that. The A key will go somewhere like this. And B will come right on top of it, just like this. this is your G sharp. The reason I know it's a G sharp is because it has this little plastic retainer on this little rod. And I know that that's G sharp because over here on the G sharp side key, there's a little rod here that attaches to that. So I know that this is going to go below my G. And the G will go somewhere here. This is a separate key. So, let's begin. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put on the G sharp. Then this top one will go right here in between. Will basically cradle the B. So then the first thing we want to do is get the rod, slide it in. This key, there's a spring on the bottom that you should probably put on. That's one of the exceptions of putting on the spring, because it's a longer spring, and there's no way of putting it on after you put on the key. Then once you successfully put the rod all the way to the back, again, screw it in. Then we'll verify that the keys move smoothly. And then afterwards, we'll put the springs on. Okay, after that, and we verified the function. Next, we're going to install the G key. And it looks good. And we'll put it on the screen. And it looks good. Next, we're going to put on the front F. Alright, it looks good. So far, we've assembled most of the main keys. Next, we're going to work on the palm keys, since those are up here. We'll set this down, and this will make it easier. And you want to look at the design of your palm keys, because each of them have their own unique design. And you want to check, because as you can see, this large palm key, this top F, has a groove in it. And that means that one of these other keys has a post that goes right through. So you want to pay attention to that. Also, you want to pay attention to what kind of springs you have and where they go. On this one, they have two little vertical lines where the spring should go in between. So that's where I'm going to put my springs. And I want to first check where each of them goes before I attach any of them. So first you put the pad on the tone hole, and then you set down the key, and you see where it goes. Now, the reason I put the front slash auxiliary F key first before I put on the palm keys is because the front F, when pressed, raises the palm key F in addition to pressing down the B key on your left hand. And on this model, it has a little arm that goes underneath the F and lifts up the F. You can see that. So you want to first put on the front F before you put the palm keys. If you do it the other way around, you're going to have a heck of a time fitting that in there. So now that the palm keys are put on, we can start on the side keys. We're going to start with the spatula. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to put on the C sharp key. Verify that it moves freely. It doesn't have any springs, so you don't have to worry about that. Now, think about what direction, you know, the spatula goes. And the C sharp is, when you're looking at it from the front, is the side key with the black roller on the left side of it. So like this. And then once you've screwed it in, you can put on the spring on the bottom. Now you can test out the function of this key. Now, this video was made according to my model of saxophone. This may differ from horn to horn. You know, some horns may have their keys on the other side of the bell. Some may have different actions, different designs for the keys. So, this is just a general look on how to take it apart, put it back together, and learn about the action of your saxophone. There we go. Took a while. So next, what we want to do is we're going to put on the side B. And be careful about how you put it on. Depending on how the low side keys are arranged, you might have to assemble them in a different order. Alright, next, on this saxophone, like I showed you earlier when I was taking it apart, the B flat and the G sharp go on the same rod, except the B flat sits on a screw at the bottom, and then the rod that goes in and holds the G sharp has a little point at the end where it goes into the B flat and holds that in. So we verify the function, they all work correctly. G sharp should stay down until you lift up. From the lowest to highest key. So that means we will start with the low B flat. Well, not the low B flat. We'll start with the B flat side key. And we'll go up to the C. Then we'll go up to the E. And they go something like this. So we'll start with this one. Last thing that's left is the octave function. On this horn, it consists of two parts. It consists of this little octave key and then the actual key press. Okay, then finally, the last thing we're going to do is we're going to put the back onto the neck. Probably at this point you're thinking, wow, I did it. I finally put it together. Yeah, the first time you do it, you're going to feel a sense of accomplishment. Not very easy to get. But once you do it, you'll have a better understanding of how your horn works. And then to verify the function of the horn, you can do one of two things. One, you can just finger a chromatic scale and verify that every key works. And there you go, it works. Thanks for watching, stick around. Please rate, comment, subscribe, and stick around. I'll have more videos dealing with saxophone. So, till next time.